After the big fire that we had, the 2019-2020 mega fire, I think we all realize how vulnerable koala are to climate change in general and to those mega fire in particular. So we really need, as a nation, really to address how we're going to protect koala and other species from those mega fire.
So the main question that we wanted to ask was if the koala densities were changing before and after the cultural burns because of those burns, and we were quite successful in highlighting that those cultural burns did not have any effect on the koala densities.
The difference between a cool burn and a hot burn, so a lot of our species and plants germinate from fire. So we've got two main species you'll see around here is Banksia and Wattle. From hot burn will come through and it'll cook all the lower vegetation and it'll burn up into the canopy and then to the higher structure. And that's what you don't want, so in a cool burn, so it'll come through and it won't burn in the mid-canopy, it'll just come through and do a light burn just under. So that's your lower canopy. It's only like from a metre to a metre and a half high is what you want to implement in a cool burn.
So we kind of, you know, used a very cutting-edge technology, drone and thermal camera, and laboratory molecular analysis to kind of add to the story of the cultural burn that have been done for millennia.
You don't want to rush a burn. Like this burn alone took 4 to 5 days to burn it. Each day we had the drone out every night looking to see where the location of the koalas were. And we came out during the day, tagged the trees that we could, you know, see where the koalas were. Last time this was burned, it was 12 years ago. Ideal time between burns is 3 to 4 years.
Minjerribah to me is a very special place. It's one of the few places in southeast Queensland where you can see koalas who are not diseased with chlamydia. So this is a very important population compared to the mainland population where a lot of koalas do have chlamydial disease. And we do see high numbers of koalas here.
WWF had helped support this project through our Regenerate Australia program. So koalas have been recently uplisted to endangered, and so every koala counts, and projects such as this are making a really important contribution to the recovery of our koalas.
Cultural burn have been happening, you know, for 10,000s of years, and that's a way to reduce the fuel load and a way to have people on country really looking at what is happening to the different ecosystem. And I think having First Nation people on country most of the time is really part of what is going to be able to change the way we manage our ecosystem in Australia.
Ideally, we'd like to see cultural burning across the whole eastern Australia where koalas are found, because it is very important and there's a lot of potential for that to happen. Yeah.